The currency that everyone's watching right now is the British pound sterling. We're in the thralls of Brexit headline drama. Last week, there was some enthusiasm about how we could be close to a Brexit deal. Now, of course, you know, the clock is really ticking because at this point, we've only got 16 days until the UK is scheduled to leave the European Union. And with each passing day, it seems like we're getting closer and closer to an agreement. Today, sterling rose 1.3%, you know, coming in as the best performing currency by far against all of the majors, because there were reports that the EU and the UK are getting very close to reaching an agreement. More specifically, Boris Johnson of the UK seems to have caved in some key issues surrounding the Irish border, and you know, there could be a possibility where, you know, most of the custom checks are done along the Irish Sea. This was a possibility that was ruled out by his predecessor, Theresa May. And at the time, she had to said no UK Prime Minister would ever accept this deal. But it seems like Boris Johnson could, and that also seems amenable to the European Union. So as a result, sterling has rallied across the board. We are closer than ever to a Brexit agreement. The language from the EU seems to be much more supportive than we've seen in the past. And as a result, not only do we see sterling rally, but we saw, you know, many of the other major currencies rally, like the euro, the US dollar against the Japanese yen. So it's kind of led to a full-blown risk-on rally. So much so that it's overshadowed UK data. Today, we had UK labor market numbers, and the numbers were weaker than expected, with claimant counts rising, as well as average weekly earnings growth slowing. So normally, that would be quite negative for sterling, but as we just talked about, sterling had a very good day, because all that matters right now is, you know, the progression of Brexit negotiations. The same will be true tomorrow when we have UK inflation data. Now, UK inflation data could actually come in better because we're seeing a small uptick in price pressures across the globe. So if UK inflation data does come in good, that could reinforce the rally. But even if it comes in weak, I think the market is going to completely discount that. We also have the U.S. retail sales report, which will certainly have an impact on all the other major currencies like dollar-yen, the euro, all the other pairs. But, you know, maybe less of an impact on sterling because we're still in the thralls of Brexit negotiations. In terms of U.S. retail sales, we saw a slowdown in wage growth, along with Johnson Redbook reporting a decline in spending. So the odds certainly favor U.S. consumers kind of cutting back in the month of September. And if we do get that, along with a stronger UK CPI report, that could be, you know, the perfect catalyst for another 1% rally in the British pound. Of course, you know, if you're trading sterling, you've got to be very careful because these negotiations could swing either way. We did have some counteractive headlines today after the initial rumors that a deal is close, including senior EU officials saying that it may be premature to expect an imminent agreement. I mean, one point or another, there's no doubt that the October 31st deadline will need to be delayed. And I think that everyone's come to realize that, which explains the recovery in sterling. But that's really what we're focusing on. The Boris Johnson still needs to get the buy-in from Parliament. He's going to have resistance from the DUP. So all of those headlines mean an ongoing roller coaster ride for sterling. And that will continue to be the main focus for the FX markets this week.